Hey there, my name's Nader Najad. You can know me as Halifax's new... What happened there?
Okay, I think I was about to have a brain aneurysm over there. I've made too many videos, I'm a little bit burnt out, but hey, alright. What's my video about? Shit. Right, how I started on YouTube here in Halifax. Multiple brain farts. Basically, I'm going to teach you exactly how to get started on YouTube in Canada and in Halifax and teach you about my tips and tricks. What you can do in order to grow on YouTube if maybe you don't have the raw talent or the skill. Because I tried making videos for a while, hard for me to grow, and then I realized, hey, no one's making videos about Halifax, so I'm gonna be the one to do it. Maybe I'll get like 50 subscribers, and now we're about 7,200 subscribers. So we have quite a few for just making videos about Halifax. I wanna get to 10K, I wanna take this channel worldwide. There's a good chance eventually one day we might get to 100K subscribers. But you know, we keep dreaming, and I'm gonna teach you exactly how I got here. Depending on how you implement my tips and tricks, you might do better or you may do worse than me, but you know what? You can do this for anywhere you are in the world to definitely, it's a sure-proof, sure-fire way to actually funnel some subscribers. And what you want to do is start with hyper-local keywording. That's tip number one. So make videos about your city, make videos about where you're at. That's what I did, and then I would tag everything I did, Halifax, Nova Scotia. So like, eating poutine. And then I use a little line thing and I put Halifax, Nova Scotia. I would do that a lot. So anytime people are looking for, you know, things to do, you know, places to eat in Halifax, my videos are gonna pop up first. And eventually, as YouTube realizes, hey, you know what, this guy is making videos about Halifax, he's kind of the one, then anytime someone's looking up Halifax, if you watch 5 random videos about Halifax, bam, I come off suggestions. It's just the way it is, because I've made 300 videos about the city. They're relevant enough for people to watch through, so YouTube says, all right, this guy's making relevant content about Halifax that people watch, and there we go. So what I didn't expect was that people internationally who were trying to move here would begin to follow me. So now I'm growing by about 20 subscribers a day. So what I recommend you do is wherever you are in Canada, do the same strategy. Talk about things in your city, bam, use a line thing, and then tag your city, tag exactly where you're at, and think about keywords people are gonna search. That leads me on a tip too. This video is about how I got started and grew on YouTube in Halifax, but to teach you how, basically you wanna do some keyword research. So look up some hot topics. Keyword research can be done in two ways. A, find things people are already doing that's working, or B, find things that no one's done before. So you can look up videos that, let's say, have 1 million views, or look up, if you follow YouTubers in your niche, you'll find some of them that actually get maybe like 200,000 views on a video that's never made before, and that's sometimes a good message for you to go ahead and make the same video. Pretty much the same video, but with your 2 cents. So that's a really good idea. You want to fill holes in the marketplace on YouTube. That's how you grow in a saturated, you know, on a saturated platform. But another thing you want to do is make videos no one's made before. Look up, I don't know, how to make llama stew. And if no one's made a video about how to make llama stew, bam, make that video, because you're definitely going to get views. Someone's going to type in llama stew one day when they're drunk, and you might get 100 views. If you say subscribe at the beginning of the video, you're going to convert maybe 10 of those 100 views into subscribers. So bam, you get 10 subscribers. Whereas if you made a video about a hot topic like, I don't know, pizza, you might get 0 subscribers. So just plug holes. It doesn't matter how small it is. Last tip, everyone says it, consistency. So I just make a lot of videos, you know. Every single day I have a video come out if I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. So sometimes I burn out, I haven't made a video for a week. If I don't make a video for a week, it means I've been extremely sick, extremely stressed, or busy. So 1 week is a really long time for me to go without making a video. I will release usually, at the bare minimum, a video every other day. Generally, almost once a day. And on good weeks, twice a day, maybe even 3 times a day in a really good phase. So it's not exactly, you know, consistent in terms of times, but my audience and my people know that I'm gonna be making videos every week. Like, chances are I'm gonna make 5 to 7 videos a week. So people stay tuned for that. They understand maybe it's not the exact same time. People don't wanna tune in like a show to watch me talk about like poutine or like how to, you know, come to Canada on the immigration pilot program. You know, people find me mostly through search, so it doesn't matter that I'm not, you know, 9 a.m. every single day, although I'm doing that now. It doesn't really matter. What matters is that I'm producing the content at a rapid pace, and it's about, you know, things people haven't made before. So there you go. That's my strategy. That's how I grew on YouTube, and that's how you can also grow on YouTube in Halifax, Canada-wide, and really anywhere you are in the world.
If you make videos about, I was speaking to someone from Jakarta today. If you make videos about Jakarta, you're gonna eventually funnel subscribers like I do. So this is something new in 2018, 2019, it's 2019 right now, but in these 2 years, this is one way to grow on YouTube, and I recommend you implement it too.